Hi everybody, real quick video, just a few pointers. Hope it helps you guys. I'm gonna make a little quick video here about top engine rebuild on a 2000 Polaris 400 two-stroke. A little information about the piston, ring clearances, and the way things go back together, so it's easier if you have any questions about it, because there are a few little tricks to it. So we have the engine all cleaned up here and ready to go, and the jug is done here. It's 20 thou over, so we're gonna get at this and I'll explain a few things for you. So here we go. One of the most common questions asked when putting a engine back together, especially two strokes or anything, but we're dealing with two strokes right now. This is a 2000 Polaris 400 two stroke, and it's been reboard or 20,000 over and honed, so it's nice and true and square again. Question with the pistons. Here's the old piston that was in there, and it has a triangle mark. It's a little bit hard to see there, right there where my thumb is. This goes to the stator side of the any engine when it's in being assembled. A lot of the pistons have an arrow that faces one way, and that is always facing your exhaust. Always. The little arrow is always facing your exhaust. So this arrow is facing forward on your piston. It faces the exhaust where your muffler comes off, your pipe. Okay. The other side is for your carburetor and your reed valve assembly. So if the arrow is on there, that goes to the front. Now you see that the arrow is facing where your piston pin is not on this example. If your piston has that arrow on the side or on the same line as your wrist pin, then it goes to your stator side, your magneto side, okay? Here's the new piston, and this one doesn't have the side arrow that matches up with the piston pin. It's got this little arrow on top here. So this one obviously just goes to the exhaust, which is usually the front of the vehicle, especially on quads and motorcycles. 99% of the time it's exhaust ported from the front, so that's done. Okay, so here's the reasoning for which way the arrow should be in your engine and has to be in your engine. And it involves exhaust ports in the cylinder heads. So this piston, it's facing forward to our exhaust, and that's because there are little dowel pins in here. A little hard to see. There's little piston ring lock pins in here. And these make sure that the rings are lined up away from any ports or opened areas in the cylinder head, which basically keeps your ring gap away from any openings. So that's the reason for those. Here's another common issue with putting some of these engines together sometime. Just gaskets, and it's a simple thing. Some of them are marked to say up. Sid, what are you barking at? Some of the gaskets are marked and they say up on them, stamped right in, okay? Some have different beveled edges on them for compression, sealing. This particular model, it actually has a cutout in it that says up on it. So this also fits, so it reads up. If you face it, put it face down, it wouldn't read anything. It'd be alien, nothing. It wouldn't say anything. This way it says up. You can see right there. It's kind of a little hard to see, but there you go. That faces up on your cylinder. That's simple. Those are really common little questions that are asked. I hope this helps you guys. Here's another good question some people have for rings and the gap that's supposed to be once they're set in the cylinder. If you want to do your end gap on your piston rings, rule of thumb for two strokes, 4 thou clearance per inch of cylinder. So this is just over a 3-inch cylinder. You're looking at about 12 to 15 thousandths. book standard on this kind of model is 7 to 15 thou clearance on your ring gaps. So if you have your little feeler gauges, you can check it out. Slide the ring in, make sure it's squared in with your piston, and then do a gap read on it. And if it's below that clearance, you can always file them down a little bit, but try to keep them exactly the same and take your time, measure, square them off properly. Most times, any machine shop you go to get your honing and boring done, you can ask them to check it for you so it matches your piston. But if you get it home and you forgot about it or they didn't do it for you, rule of thumb, every inch of bore, 4 thou clearance. Okay? Pretty simple. Good luck with your build.